Let us discuss about isoniazid. What is this isoniazid and how it works? What is the mechanism behind working and what side effects? What are the uses? All these things we will see in this lecture. As all of us know, in first line treatment of tuberculosis, we have five drugs. We have five drugs in first line treatment of tuberculosis. Among those five drugs, this isoniazid is also one drug. Clear? So isoniazid is mainly used in treatment of tuberculosis, right? Now let's understand how it works in tuberculosis. This isoniazid, it kills rapidly proliferating mycobacterium. Right? And it inhibits slow multiplying mycobacterium. And this isoniazid, it works both intracellular, it kills both intracellular mycobacteria and extracellular mycobacteria, right? So it kills both intra and extracellular mycobacteria. Now let's understand the mechanism behind this, behind its work. Mechanism of action. The mechanism of action is, it inhibits synthesis of mycolic acid. This mycolic acid is specific to mycobacterium. It's present only in mycobacterium, and this production is inhibited. Hence, it kills that mycobacterium. Let's understand how this mycolic acid is inhibited. This mycolic acid is coded by two genes. One is INHBE and CASA gene. These two genes, they encode this mycolic acid. Clear? Now, when you give isoniazid, this isoniazid will be acted upon by an enzyme in the mycobacterium. Okay, it is acted upon by an enzyme called catalase peroxidase. Okay, after being acted upon by this enzyme, this forms reactive metabolite. This forms reactive metabolite. Okay, this reaction will take place in mycobacterium, right? So when you give isoniazid, this isoniazid will be converted to a reactive metabolite by an enzyme called catalase peroxidase. Now this reactive metabolite will combine with NADP and forms NADP adduct. Okay, this adduct, NADP adduct, what it does is, it goes and inhibits this. Okay, now this adduct, what it does is, it goes and inhibit this INHBE and CASA genes. So as these two genes are inhibited, it results in less production or inhibition of production of mycolic acid. Clear? This is how isoniazid inhibit mycolic acid production. Clear? So let me revise this mechanism once again. This mycolic acid is specific to mycobacterium. This is present only in mycobacterium. This mycolic acid is encoded by two genes called INHBE and CASA genes. Clear? Now coming to isoniazid. Isoniazid when it goes into mycobacterium, it is acted upon by an enzyme called catalase peroxidase enzyme. After being acted upon by this enzyme, isoniazid will get converted to reactive metabolite, right? Reactive metabolite. This reactive metabolite of isoniazid will combine with NADP and forms NADP adduct. This NADP adduct will go on inhibit in here and cause a genes, right? This results in inhibition of mycolic acid production that kills the mycobacterium. This is a mechanism of action. Now let's understand how resistance develops to isoniazid. Resistance will be developed by mycobacterium by developing mutations in caseon inhibitor genes. When there are mutations in these two genes, it results in development of resistance. Or when there is mutation in this catalase peroxidase enzyme, it results in development of resistance. Okay, so the two important mechanisms of development of resistance is, one is mutation in inhibitor and caseon gene. The second is development of mutation in catalase and peroxidase enzyme. These two are mechanisms for development of resistance, right? This is about resistance. And one important thing that we have to remember here is about resistance is, there is no cross resistance with other drugs. I mean with other anti-tubercular drugs. Okay. What we can say is no cross resistance with other anti-tubercular drugs. So this is about resistance. Now let's understand pharmacokinetics. Pharmacokinetics. If take pharmacokinetics, this drug will be absorbed orally, right? And after oral absorption, it goes into almost all the tissues. It can enter into almost any tissue in the body. Clear? And next, metabolism. Metabolism will take place in liver. In the liver, metabolism will take place by N-acetylation, right? This N-acetylation, the rate of this N-acetylation will differ among people. In some people, this action is very fast. This N-acetylation is very fast. Whereas in some people, this N-acetylation is very slow. Based on this, people are the community is divided into fast acetylators and slow acetylators. Okay, slow acetylators and fast acetylators. Clear? And if see in slow acetylators, we'll see some side effects specifically. Mainly, isoniazid induced peripheral neuritis. Isoniazid induced peripheral neuritis. This side effects is more commonly seen in this slow acetylators. We can also see in fast acetylators, but more commonly in slow acetylators. That means they are more prone for this side effect, right? Now let's understand interactions. If take interaction, the absorption of isoniazid will be reduced by aluminum hydroxide. So aluminum hydroxide will decrease absorption, right? And rifampin. This rifampin, what it does is, it is an enzyme inducer. So as it is enzyme inducer, it results in इट काजेज फास्ट मेटाबॉलिज्म ऑफ आइसोनियाज, राइट? सो व्हाट आर द टू इम्पॉर्टेंट ड्रग्स दैट अफेक्ट एल्युमिनियम मेटाबॉलिज्म? वन इज सॉरी टू इम्पॉर्टेंट ड्रग्स दैट अफेक्ट आइसोनियाज मेटाबॉलिज्म इज आर वन इज एल्युमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड, द सेकंड वन इज रिफम्पिन. एल्युमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड इट डिक्रीजेस अब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ आइसोनियाजिन, वेर आर रिफम्पिन इट्स एन एंजाइम इंड्यूसर, सो इट हास्टेंस द मेटाबॉलिज्म ऑफ आइसोनियाजिन. ओके, एंड देर आर other drugs which gets affected by this isoniazid. See, these two drugs are the drugs which affect the metabolism of isoniazid, right? Now there are certain other drugs which gets affected by isoniazid. Now isoniazid is going to affect other drugs. Let's see what are those drugs. This isoniazid, it decreases the metabolism of other drugs like phenytoin, carbamazepine, theophylline, warfarin, okay, etc. Other these are the main important drugs. So this is about interaction. Now let's understand adverse effects. In the body there is a step like pyridoxine will be converted to pyridoxal phosphate, right? This is the step that goes on in our body, right? Isoniazid, what it does is it affects this step due to effect on this step there is development of peripheral neuritis and other neurological manifestation. Okay, so pyridoxine affects conversion of pyridoxine to pyridoxal phosphate, and that results in development of neurological symptoms and peripheral neuritis. Okay, and if you want to prevent this adverse effect, you have to give pyridoxine supplementation. Okay, and other important side effect is liver damage. What this isoniazid does is it causes damage to liver cells, and this results in hepatitis. But luckiest thing here is it is completely reversible if you stop the drug, then liver can come to its normal state. Clear? This is about isoniazid. Thank you for watching.